Hi, Bob Anderson back again. In the last video, we talked about locating a deal. We talked about how one of the students came up with a deal, potential four townhouse project, and how we quickly jumped on it when we could see that the numbers were going to work. Today, I'd like to take you through a little bit forward of that, if you like, the contract stage, the actual acquisition stage, because that's important as well. And it will vary from state to state. When we're talking about real estate contracts, they're a state by state thing. And in each state, they have their own little quirks. Called New South Wales, you've got exchanges. And in other states, let's say Queensland, you go straight to a contract with conditions. So it's a little bit different in every state. And if you're not familiar with how contracts work, then you need to do that. Also, things like auctions. I mean, how can you buy a property? Well, it could be by auction, could be by tender, could be by private treaty, where it's actually listed at a particular price. Or it could be by negotiation when there's no price at all. So all these different ways of acquiring a property. You know, if you lived in Melbourne, where probably, if you like, that's the auction capital of Australia, that's where a lot of deals are done by auction, then you're gonna have to get used to buying at auction. Now, if you're gonna do that, then you better do your due diligence early. You have to know exactly what that property's worth, if it's gonna be any good for you, and set yourself a figure and not go past it. In the next video, I'll take you more into the due diligence side of a deal, the sort of things we look for to make sure is a deal, but today I just want to talk more about the contractual side. In this particular case, I'll refer to this four townhouse project as a case study. It was a situation where the owner of the property was going to list it at a particular price. So the owner had taken advice, I guess, their own advice from agents, had a look at other sales in the area, whatever, and had come up with a figure. Now, that particular figure happened to be $750,000. And as I said, I did my numbers, my five-minute FISO that I teach all my students. I did it based on that number and a bit more detailed due diligence that I'll cover in the next video to decide if a deal was a deal. And so the next day, proceeded straight to a contract. Now, as I said, the market was a bit hot. I didn't want to let it sit around, wanted to jump on this deal. So we got a contract in front of the owner, the seller, very quickly, before it had actually officially hit the market. Now, this particular project happened to be in Queensland where I live, and so we could go straight to a contract with conditions. So there were a few conditions I wanted to put in this contract. First of all, I wanted to put a due diligence clause in there. So I chose a due diligence clause of 14 days. Now, what does that mean? Well, it means that the contract is subject to satisfactory due diligence. Satisfactory on, if you like, on my behalf, that I've done all the due diligence that I want, that things are coming up trumps, and I want to proceed on that basis. And as I said, in the next video, I'll take you through that due diligence process. So I wanted 14 days to do that. Do I need 14 days? No, look, I can do due diligence in a matter of hours unless there's something particularly quirky about a particular site where I might need to take advice from, say, an engineer or something like that. Normal situation can do due diligence quite fast, but I wanted to give myself that time just to really dig deep. Also, I made it subject to finance. In other words, a further 21 days finance at the end of the due diligence period. So the situation is, signed a contract, subject to 14 days due diligence. Now, if everything comes up trumps on that 14 days, I say due diligence is fine, that condition's dealt with. Now we go into a 21 days finance clause for me to arrange the finance. Now, we actually got a longer contract on this one. We actually got a 90-day contract. Part of the reason was that we didn't argue about the price. We didn't try and negotiate. I thought, look, it's gonna just work at 750. I want this deal. I don't wanna get bogged down in a hot market talking about dollars and cents where somebody else could come in under me and grab it. So I took it at full price. Now, the owner of the property knew that they were selling a potential development site. In fact, the house that was sitting on it was a bit of a shocker. So the $750,000 I was paying for this site wasn't house value. It was, if you like, what it was worth as a potential development site. I knew that. I was prepared to pay that sort of money. And so I needed a finance clause to know that I could go to the bank and get the finance done and settle in the 90 days. Now, part of the reason for the 90 days as well is that I could proceed and get started on the development application before I even settled on the land. So that helped with holding costs. Also, and I had another clause in there for access because I needed access to this particular property. As it turned out, this was a rental, so the owner of the land was renting it out, but I did need access. I wanted to be able to go on the site with the town planner, with the architect. I needed to get a surveyor on there to do a survey so I could proceed with the development application before I even settled on the land. So simply an access clause is one that gives you permission to enter the site. And in this particular case, the sort of finance that I was going to get is what we call a retail loan. So technically, I wasn't buying a development site, because as far as the banks are concerned, it's not technically a development site until you have a development approval or a development permit. At this point, I was just buying an investment property. It was basically a pretty shabby old house on a block of land with development potential. But because it had no development approval, the banks just consider it an investment. If you like, I was paying over the odds for an old investment. And that's just a normal retail bank, you know, just a normal investment loan, a simple 80-20 loan or whatever happens to come out at, depending on the valuation. And I'll cover the finance in more detail in a future video. But at the moment, so there we go. So it's under contract, 90 days contract, 14 days due diligence, followed by 21 days finance, access to let me on site. And so I was able to wrap up the finance in that period and proceed to lodge the development application. I'll go through that in more detail in coming videos. So I hope you're enjoying this. It's sure, it's all about property development, but it's also a great case study. I look forward to seeing you in the next episode.